Maybe you've been hearing about SQL data classification over the years, but did you know that for the last few years, we've actually integrated with Microsoft Information Protection? Learn all about it and how it will track your lineage from the column level all the way to your Power BI reports this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Madhu. Madhu, thanks so much for joining us today. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Hey, Anna. I'm very happy to be here. So, hi, viewers. My name is Madhu. I'm a product manager in Azure Data and Security team. I currently focus on multiple security features like SQL data classification, dynamic data masking, and there are some integration work with Microsoft Purview, which is going on, and you will be hearing about it very soon. But yes, so I work on all these features.
Awesome. Cool. Well, it's great to have you on the show. We're going to have you on the show again because we got to learn more about all of these things you're working on and some of the new things with Purview in the future. But today we're going to be talking about SQL data classification and maybe some of the new things that are happening in that space. I don't know. So let's kick off. Can you tell us for folks who aren't familiar with SQL data classification, like what is it, where do you get it, and how does it work?
Sure, Anna. Yeah, so actually, this is a kind of brush up session about SQL data classification feature, because as most of you must be knowing that this feature is available since SQL Server 2012 and is available in all the Azure SQL flavors. And it's available in the latest version of SQL Server as well. But we had done some enhancements in the year of 2022, wherein we had introduced MIP-based classification, which is Microsoft Information Protection Policy-based labeling in SQL database. That's kind of new, and we heard that, you know, that there is some issues with, you know, understanding what is SQL information protection, what is Microsoft information protection, and there is some confusion. So we thought that we could arrange this short session and kind of bring that clarity. So we are going to talk about overall what this feature is all about, and then talk about a bit more about MIP and what are the advantages that you get when you use MIP-based labeling in SQL database. So let's get started. As I mentioned, this is a security feature, and what it provides are, you can categorize it in, you know, three kind of stages. The first one is if you have no understanding about what kind of secure data or sensitive data is there in your database, you can use this feature, which is a built-in feature in SQL Engine. You don't need to pay extra to avail this feature. And you can, when you go to the browser, there's your portal, you see data discovery and classification blade. So when you go to this blade, automatically the recommendation engine gets kicked off in the backend, and it scans the database, gives you recommendation on whatever sensitive columns it could find out. If it doesn't find anything, well, that's good. But if it finds anything, then it provides you the list of recommendation. And let me call out this point that the recommendation in engine works based on the column name, not the actual data which is stored in the column. And this is a very simple design today was available. So once you get the list of recommendation, you can, you know, review it and see if it makes sense, validate it, accept those recommendation, or you can ignore it. Or if you are a data owner, you have good understanding about what data is stored in the database, you can go and do your own classification. So the next thing is, how does SQL Server or Azure SQL find out that these are the columns which are sensitive in the database, right? So it uses, by default, there is a SQL information protection policy which comes with this feature. And even you can, you know, customize that policy file. You can import your own custom policy file. Apart from that, there is something new that we introduced in the year 2022, which is Microsoft Information Protection Policy. And whoever would have used Microsoft 365, or if you have you know, the E3 and E5 license, right, you would have seen in Office or in your email, you can you can label your email or you can label your doc. So same concept we have extended to SQL Server or Azure SQL, wherein you can use these MIP labels and classify your data inside the SQL database. So what you get out of is you kind of have a standard set of labels that you are using in Office. And now, and the same was in, you know, understood by Power BI. Now it is understood by Azure SQL database. So that means you, yeah, Anna.
One question for you there. Maybe you were going to just say that, but I was just curious, like I've seen the like highly confidential business, those sorts of, I'm assuming those are MIP labels. When it comes to a database, does it apply at the whole database level? Do you do it at like table level or how does that work?
Yeah, that's a great question. Today we support these labeling at the column level.
Oh,
so
wow.
That's the granularity. But yes, we have planned to, you know, support different kind of objects at a table level, database level later, but this is what is supported today.
Cool.
Yeah. And so let me also give a brief about what is sensitivity label and what is classification or information type. So sensitivity label is the severity of the data, means like as you mentioned, confidential, highly confidential or general. And when you say information type, it is more about what kind of data it is. Is it a SSN number? Is it a credit card number? So it gives you more info about the type of data. So, yeah, as I mentioned, so through MIP, you get those standard set of labels, which are understood by different kind of applications. Now you, you know, label your data within SQL database, which is a source. Someone creates a Power BI report where they pull this data to a Power BI report. And along with the data, the label also gets pulled or propagated to Power BI, and your report gets automatically classified. Why? Because Power BI also understands MIP. It doesn't understand the SQL native labels, but it understands MIP. And again, you export that data to an Excel. So again, Office understands MIP. So in that way, the label gets propagated automatically from SQL to Power BI to Excel.
Wow, so that's awesome. You can see how anyone tracking governance would be really happy to hear that this is finally kind of flowing through like that.
Yes. Yeah. It's been there, and there is more work happening in that area. We will be keeping you updated. But yes, so that's the current.
Cool. Well, it's been around. Now people know if they didn't know. Can we see it in action? I'd love to see it.
So we could, we'll show you both the policies and how do you label the data. And the last one is, yes, your data has been classified. You can export and, you know, share the report or save it for later auditing and stuff. Another good part of, you know, labeling your data is like, maybe I can just go to the next slide and then we'll go to the demo. So the value propositions that you get here is once you kind of identify where the sensitive data lies, you classify that sensitive data. Now that acts as a foundation, right, for your next security measures. Like you can think of implementing encryption, or you can, you know, enforce better access control mechanism because you know that there is, you know, credit card details or SSN number in the database, or you kind of control how that data will be shared with vendors or other teams. So kind of it improves the overall security posture for that database and your organization. And apart from that, we talked about how the label can automatically propagate, right, from source to the point of consumption. And also you can meet a lot of compliance requirements and data privacy standards and regulations that's there in the market. So let's quickly go to the Azure portal and let's see it in action. So I'm connected to one of the Azure SQL database that you can see AdventureWorks DW. So when you go to the security section, you can see data discovery and classification. So once you click on this blade, you see this, the first page which gets loaded, that's kind of give you a pie chart of, you know, the distribution of sensitive data in the database. And you see these numbers because I have already classified some of these columns using the sensitivity labels or information types. Here you see the details in a tabular format, and you can export this information and save it or share it as you need. Apart from that, we were talking about two policies that SQL or Azure SQL supports today when it comes to data classification and labeling. So you can see there is SQL Information Protection Policy and Microsoft Information Protection Policy. So SQL Information Protection Policy is the default one. I have now switched to MIP, and that's why this is the option which is selected. So let me show you how do you label your data using MIP, because that's something pretty new in comparison to SQL Information Protection Policy, which was there. So let me close this and go to the Classification tab. So if you see here, there are some of these columns I have already classified. And if I want to classify a new column, I can click on Add Classification, select a specific schema. Let's say I can select DBO and select any of the table, let's say customer table, and let's see if there is any column which is not classified. I can just choose for demo purpose, let's say customer name. And information type is always NA when you have set the information protection policy as MIP. And then the set of labels that you see here, it is actually getting pulled from Microsoft 365. And these are the labels which have already been defined in the compliance portal. And the user that I have connected now is authenticated, and these labels are already published to this user, and that's why you see the list of labels here. Now I can choose any one of these labels, maybe confidential all employees, and click on Add Classification. You see this marker. So this is a new classification we are adding. So let's save it. So once this is saved, it is saved into the database and persisted, right? So, and you can see this is a list of sensitivity labels, and they are mapping with the against the columns. And if you want to query this metadata, you can go to SSMS and just run a query against sys.sensitivityclassification. So that's the catalog view. And let me check the database context. Yes, this we are connected to the right DB. Now let's query this particular catalog view. So you can see that you can query these classification and label information inside the database. If you want to, you know, script it out, or you want to save it for future, you can save it, and yeah, you can replay this in other environments if you think that this is useful. Another thing I want to point out, so Anna, let me know if there is a question, or I'll just go to the Power BI section.
No, this is great. And I love how in real time we see that column that you added classification for. Yeah.
Yeah. So yes, so I have already connected and I have just run a query, because this takes a bit of, couple of seconds to get reflected. But the point is this, that when you query the data from SQL database and the columns have already been classified, automatically the Power BI report gets classified. So here the report says that it is highly confidential specific people, or down even you can see here it is highly confidential specific people. So so you can see that once the column has been classified in the database, you need not classify the report again. Automatically the label propagates to Power BI, but definitely you can override this particular label if you think that this is not appropriate, or you want to have a more stricter label in the Power BI report for whatever reason. And then when you export the data to Excel or any other Office application, this label will automatically propagate to those applications.
Wow, cool. That's awesome. Madhu, thanks so much for sharing this with us. I think personally, I learned a lot. It's cool to see how we've kind of evolved from SQL information protection to MIP policy and just kind of aligning with M365. My last question is, like, if you were using SQL information protection before, like the old, maybe old's not the right word, the other original classic data classification, is your advice that everyone should start to use MIP, or like kind of wait and see what your organization does? Like, what's your take?
Yes. So, if you already have Office E3 or E5 license and you are actually using these MIP labels in Office or Power BI, then we would recommend using that in the SQL database so that you can get advantage of this end-to-end propagation of labels from SQL to Power BI and Office. But if you have specific requirement wherein, you know, you need to have classification or information type along with sensitivity label, then the SQL information protection policy provides you that flexibility. As you saw in the demo, while classifying a column, I couldn't select information type. It was NA when it comes to MIP policy because it is only sensitivity label which is supported today. But if you have a special requirement where you want to have information type, which will say this is a credit card, this is a SSN, then yes, SQL information protection policy is something that will give you that flexibility, Anna. But so let me also call out this point because there is a lot of work happening in the area of MIP and integration with Microsoft Purview. So as a company, as you know, Microsoft, so we are heading towards more of MIP integration, bringing everything together on the foundation of MIP. So yeah, you should take a serious look at MIP policy and see how it can best suit your need. And let us know if you have any questions or issues or any feedback that you want to bring to our notice. Definitely feel free to reach out to us. And we are actually collecting a lot of feedback in this area and we'll be happy to connect with you and learn more about your requirements.
Awesome. Cool. Well, thanks so much. I learned a lot. I think our viewers learned a lot. Your answer right there really helped give me and I think the viewers a lot more clarity on like, okay, what is MIP and how should we think about it? If you like this episode, go ahead, give it a like, leave us a comment and let us know what you think. And if you have any feedback for us, we'll put some links in the description for you to learn more. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.